Hey guys, everybody, the video. So in today's video, we are going to be going raccoon trapping. I got this trap. I got my trap and bucket, and I came down to the trap. I just set about 3 days ago, and on the third day, boom. What's up, buddy?
What's up, my guy? What's up? Hi.
All right, guys, so that coon is now, I put it in a trash bag, and I'm going to skin it when I get home. If any of y'all are wondering why I kill these raccoons after I've trapped them, what I do with these raccoons is I take them home, I skin them, and then once I'm done skinning them, I go and I put them in the freezer and then eat them later on. The best way for me to just state this right now is if y'all don't like me going out here and killing these raccoons, the only thing I can say is God made them for us to eat them, so I'm going to go ahead and eat them while they're here. And that's the second one I've trapped. I let one go. That wasn't the one that I trapped because he hasn't his foot. Because I just trapped that raccoon like 2 days ago, so there's no way his foot could have healed that quick. But I don't just trap these guys to go out and trap them and have fun. Now some people do. If you're that person, I'm sorry. But anywho, like I said, I trap these guys because they're here for me to eat, and I'm gonna eat them. And I think they're good if they're cooked a certain way. Some people might not think that. Some people look at raccoons as animals that get in your trash can. I see them as food. Also see squirrels that way. I'll get my dad out here with us. That way we can film it together. That way we can film it and not get it taken down by YouTube. I'll get him out there and we can go squirrel hunting with my dad's old 22 too, maybe. And my 22. We just have my dad behind the camera or something, so that way YouTube doesn't take it down right as I post it. But anywho, I just wanted to clear that up for y'all. I don't just go out here and trap these raccoons for the fun of it. I go out here, trap them, put them in the freezer, and later on go ahead and eat them. And this trap circle stinks to high heaven. That raccoon stunk. And he was probably digging in the school's food. In the school's trash cans. Honestly, I wouldn't blame them. Them trash cans probably have more food than my house does. I'll get back to you guys in just a minute. So I got the... Must be a squirrel. I got the tuna. I hate tuna. Oh, me. What we're going to do is take it, put it right back here. In that back corner. And then we're just going to let it sit there. I got it in the same spot I just trapped this coon. Now I'm going to go reset the other trap. Alright, so this is where it all happened at the trap last video. We just got this trap. What we're going to do is bang on it. Try to get all this dirt out real quick. Start a time lapse. Alright, so now it's cleaned out. What we're going to do is we're going to take this little tool right here. I'll zoom it in. What it does is it goes right here. Goes in between these forks. Then you do this. Step on it. Then you have this little latch right here. Take it. Step on it. It's all muddy. It's hard to do this. Set it like that. Get that out. Put it where I put it last time. Right there. I got a dog food, cat food mixture that stinks. If you want to, all you do is put bait on in it. Not all the way like I just did. Then put it around it. Then what you can do, if you feel like, you can put fish oil like some people do. You can put maple syrup. Some people even put a golf ball on top to make sure and see if the golf ball's off. And if it is, I'll go over there and check on it and see if it's at. That's only for people that have a long trap line of like 20 traps. Some people even have 40. That's me. I put like 5 or 6 out. I go check them all. And sometimes I'll have one. One time I got 2. One time I even had like 3 or 4 out of my trap line. And for me, I can trap about 4. I'll keep 2, skin them up, and then let the other 2 go because I can't skin 4 in one night. Really, that one, I didn't really want to keep it, but I did because I wanted the meat, and I've got time today. So what I'm going to do is go on the next trap and do this. This time, I'm going to go set it on a creek. So come with me while I go set it. Now we're going to move on to the next type of set you can set. All right, so we're going to choose this pine tree right here, really sturdy. We're going to take this wire. Start a time lapse. Let me put the wire on real quick. All right, so now that's on there good. Now what we're gonna do is do the same thing we did to set that one trap up close. Take these pins. Put them down here. This one's already had a raccoon on it, so it should make it better. Pull it down. Y'all can see it. Push it down. And put it like that. And then put it on this little trigger right here. Now that thing is set and live and ready to go. Put it right. There. And what we're gonna do, pull it up around halfway and take all this bait, sprinkle it around. That's good. This one might take 1 day, it might take 2 days, might take 3 days, might take a week. I don't know. But we're gonna give it as long as it needs. And now let's I'll just share some wisdom with you that I know. Depending on your price range, if you have $50 to go out and spend, get 2 or 3 dog proofs. I'm sure you have a cat or dog at home. Use some dog and cat food. And you don't even need that thing I used to set it. Before I had that tool, what I used was a flathead screwdriver and did the same with it. I just did it down like that. Except I use a flathead screwdriver because I didn't have one of those tools yet. But now that I have that tool, it makes it a lot easier. But if you are getting into it, you start liking it, you have a little more money, you're willing to spend on it, you go to live traps, move on to those. Those are probably they are the easiest way to catch a raccoon. Because they just put their paw in there, and they don't know what it is, and then they just, then they get caught, and you just dispatch them, take their foot out, and do that. But anywho, the easiest way I would say to cook them is make a roast. What I did is I put the meat in there, then I put the meat tenderizer, you can get it at Dollar General. And then what I did is I let it cook for around 30-45 minutes, slow on medium or low, one. And then I put my taters, carrots, onions, and then whatever you want, radishes. I don't really care what you want. It's up to you. And then let it cook for another 45 minutes. But get it out, salt and pepper it. And if once you've got the taters and stuff in there, you can put your favorite seasoning in there and stuff like I did. And it makes it a lot better. But anywho, that's just what I did for this trip. I'm going to put this back in there. I will do a how to cook a raccoon video pretty soon for y'all because I have a feeling y'all might want to see that. Just so that way I can show y'all how to cook one. I'm not going to do the clean one because I don't really want to show me cleaning it mainly because YouTube will take it down. Or if I do start making money, they'll demonetize it. But anywho, if y'all want these raccoon trapping videos coming out more often, comment down below. But anywho, I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.